Today is a very sunny March 22nd, 2022. Here I am again, Grand Central Terminal, Metro North's Imperial Palace. And I'm about to embark on another Metro North adventure, riding train 943 from here to Wassaic, a distance on the Harlem line of 82 miles. And riding this train, I would have ridden as far as you can ride on a Metro North train from here on either the Hudson, New Haven, or Harlem line. Although some will probably criticize me for not riding between Union Station and State Street in New Haven, but for all intents and purposes, I will cover all the lines other than connecting lines like New Canaan, Danbury, Waterbury, etc. Now I know there are some doubting Thomases out there who think I don't give a damn about Metro North, but I think lately I've proved that I have given it a great deal of interest riding the trains. They instead think I'm more interested in romancing and falling in love with New Jersey Transit. Indeed, New Jersey Transit has beautiful low locomotives. You can't argue with that compared to the roster of locomotives Metro North has. But, you know, give credit where credit is due. Metro North does serve interesting countryside on all the lines and provides a historical view in some parts of the various counties north of New York City. There's the train right there. Departs 343, train 943. One of the two through trains to Wassaic. Note the bottom, the sign of things to come. By the end of this year, it should open. Going to be something else. Well, you can bet when the Long Island Railroad starts opening their East Side Access project to run trains into here, you can bet retired rail fan will be out there chronicling as many aspects of that operation as possible. And if the M3s come back, hopefully I can get a head-end ride into Grand Central. They were supposedly coming back with this March 21st schedule change, but so far that has not come to pass. I've heard all kinds of yeses and nos about them coming back. I don't know what to believe, but they think by the time the East Side Access Project opens that they'll need every piece of MU equipment they can get their hands on. So let's keep our fingers crossed. Hope for the best. And here on track 37 is our train, train 943, through train to Wassaic on the Upper Harlem Line. And here's our locomotive on 943, P32ACDM221, otherwise known as Jenny's by employees. And right next door we have a downwardly consecutive numbered P32220.
All right, time is 343. From track 37. I'm on board Condot Car Bethel, or Bethel. See an M3 over there. Metro North still has a sizable fleet of well-maintained M3s. Starting up his diesel engine. It's usually by the time they get to 125th, they're already in diesel. Even before that. Sounds like he's still in electric mode. Ooh, so some sparks flying. Still in E mode because the power is cutting out periodically. Once he has his diesel engine on, the HEP provides constant electricity. It doesn't come from the third rail. Ooh, man, he's really sparking. Ooh. might have already started his diesel engine. Still throwing up sparks. You can see them. You can see the sparks. I'm told these engines are rather inferior in electric mode. Accuse the railroad of not announcing the stops.
Thank you.
engine so I can hear it. Okay, turn in to go over the Harlem River Bridge. Some of my narration will duplicate my Poughkeepsie trip. There's that railroad connector for freight. It connects to Oak Point Yard for CSX trains coming down to Hudson. Major Deegan Expressway looks pretty crowded. Okay, this is where the old 138th Street stop used to be. It's been gone for about 30 or 40 years now. CP5, MO, Mott Haven Junction, whatever way you want to call it. This is where the Hudson Line continues off. I see an MA coming off the Hudson Line. It's an odd sight considering they run primarily on the New Haven Line, but sometimes they do go up that way. Probably had some work done in the Harmon shop. Oh, back in New York Central days, we stored a lot of passenger cars here. Mott Haven Yard. Those North White Plains clunkers. They make tons of stops. They travel only a short distance to North White Plains. When you ride on a North White Plains local, sometimes it seems like you never get to where you're going. Engineers who like to run trains fast hate getting those jobs, because you just can't do it. Stop here in addition to the Harlem Line trains. This is CP 109. On the Harlem Lines, the CP numbers are preceded by a 1. An M3. Conductor Paul loves those. Hotel in New York City. I don't know if that's true or not, but I'm not about to take a vacation there to find out. I don't doubt the heavy-duty rail fanning you can have from there, though. All right, here's where the New Haven line takes off. There's one of their tracks going overhead. Trains you see from here on out are strictly Harlem Line. Harlem Line parallels a number of important roads. There's an M7A. The road you see out there, that's the Bronx River Parkway. Wakefield, last station in the Bronx. Here we enter Westchester County, and we'll be in Westchester County all the way to around Croton Falls. A lot of traffic on the Bronx River Parkway today. There's Mount Vernon West. There's a Mount Vernon East on the New Haven line.
CP 117.
two tracks. We're on track one, that's track two. And the Bronx River Parkway is back with us again. This part of Westchester is rather attractive with the hiking trails along the river. Very nice towns. Westchester County, White Plains, quite a large metropolis in its own right. Shuttles that ran out of Brewster up to Pauling and Dover Plains, and MUs always terminated in North White Plains. But before the Penn Central absorbed the New Haven, they used to have engine changes on the Brewster trains at White Plains North. There used to be a station there called Holland Avenue. It's no longer there. They'd swap the engines out, and going into New York, they'd swap them out at White Plains North Station. Funny thing happened when Penn Central absorbed the New Haven back in January 1st of 1969. They drastically cut their passenger service between New York and Boston and New York and Springfield, Mass. That freed up a lot of FL9s. And guess where those FL9s went? Here. They would power the trains to Brewster from Grand Central without a locomotive change. Well, there were a few trains that change locomotives, but they're the exception rather than the rule. I distinctly remember going to White Plains North Station in the summer of 69 and seeing all these Brewster trains going by with New Haven painted FL9s. It was a weird sight. They've implemented some very strange practices on this line over the years. I'll mention it later. Back when I was at White Plains North back then, I saw an S-Class electric locomotive bringing a train going to Brewster. Those S-Class motors were built like around the turn of the century. They were just about ready to retire them at that time. Other electric that they ran on this line back in Central days and early PC were the T-Class electrics. I don't think they ran the cut motors up here, but they might have, possibly. I don't know. But the FL9s took over pretty much up here after the New Haven absorption by PC. Well, here's White Plains North now. Looks a lot different than the one I saw in 1969. It's pretty much a platform on the side. M3s. Oh, Harlem Line uses a lot of M3s, I find. Now, as soon as we leave here, we're going to pass by the North White Plains Yard, and then we're going to hit our first railroad crossing. And there are many on this line. It's Virginia Road. sides of the train. There's a GP35R used on work trains. North in 1969, hear these Brewster trains coming down into New York and hearing those FL9s blowing those Hancock air whistles for Virginia Road. It's a weird sound to hear. Coming up on Valhalla here, passing by the Valhalla Depot, old station, which is a restaurant. On the other side, and here's Valhalla Station. All the stations on this line up to Brewster and southeast are island platforms. We're not stopping at Valhalla. Our next stop is Chappaqua on this. Back in 2015, just north of here, there was a disastrous accident. An SUV went through the crossing, the gates came down, this woman was stuck on the track. She didn't know what to do. The train hit it. Ripped up third rail, killed and injured a lot of people. Now this area here is Cemetery Row. This line was electrified north of White Plains North to Brewster and Southeast, 1984. Prior to that, there used to be a station around here called Kensico Cemetery. That was discontinued with the electrification. It was redundant to the Mount Pleasant station, which serves the cemetery. I think the Kensico Cemetery station was right here. Yep. See the sign on the building. Now, the Harlem line exhibited some peculiar practices. I think that crossing is where that accident happened, but don't quote me. You look at the cemetery here. Soon you'll see the Mount Pleasant station that serves the cemetery. It's just a little tiny platform. If you blink, you'll miss it. This place is immense. RDC trains, maybe two or three cars, and when they got to White Plains North, a locomotive electric would come along and take it to New York. On the way back, the reverse would be true. They cut off the electric locomotive and the RDCs would make it up to Brewster on its own power. But while running between North White Plains and Grand Central, the diesel engines on the RDCs themselves provided power for the lights and heat, no propulsion. So there really wasn't much in the way of pollution. Back, I think, in 1970, I rode an RDC out of Brewster. Here's the Hawthorne station. I rode an RDC train out of Brewster. It was two cars. When it got to White Plains North, they backed an MU consist onto the front. And that MU train dragged us into Grand Central. Of course, those type of trains with the butt cars on them, they have to use the loop tracks because the butt cars can't MU to the MU cars. So they can't go north out of that same track. They have to be pulled through. And that's why they go around the loop. Okay, this road here should be the Taconic Parkway.
State 684.
Lows 32.3. Chappaqua, the home of the Clintons and the former home of Reader's Digest. line, this line has lots of railroad crossings. Sawmill River Parkway that ends on Interstate 684, and that road is now paralleling us on the right side. Pretty much runs relatively close to us all the way up to southeast.
through the doors in the first car and the last of the three cars that will not open.
In the Lucille Ball show when she lived in some upstate town with Vivian Vance. They went to Brewster and the cop gave them a ticket, illegal parking or something or other, and they were yelling at the cop, blah, 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 blah. The cop just answered them, "Welcome to Brewster." stick out this way. Southeast. We'll make little stops to White Plains and then run express to 125th Street. Was accessed down that way. other side is the MU yard for Southeast. This is where the electric trains terminate, but we will keep right on going. Central and Penn Central days, this section of track was pretty much the domain of RDC trains to Pauling and Dover Plains and locomotive haul trains to Chatham.
lake or reservoir out there. On the other side is Metro North's Beacon Line. That runs from Danbury to Beacon. They still own it, but it's supposedly leased out to the Housatonic Railroad. That line will cross over us further north around Dykeman's. I think it's Dykeman's. Should see that track course overhead here somewhere. Parallels us for a few miles. That line used to be the route that the freights took going to Maybrook. Little town of
almost 61. And before we arrive at Pauling, we'll enter Dutchess County. Southeast Wassaic trains. Good track, kind of a laid-back operation. W-L-I-N-G. All the stations have high platforms. This used to be a terminus for RDC trains years ago. doesn't look particularly good with the leaves off the trees. I'm going to start making my way back to where I can get off the train at Wassaic, but try to get as much of the ride as I can. Some kind of an old industrial track here. It's like an old power plant. Like much. This is Harlem Valley Wingdale. All of Vet University is here. Here it is. I think it's occupying the old Harlem Valley Hospital. It used to be some kind of a asylum. Next stop is Dover. Dover Plains, known affectionately around here by locals as Dover. There's another controlled sighting. Dover was the terminus of the trains for quite a while, from 1972 to 2000, when service was revived up to Wassaic. Walking at those old diesel locomotives, those EMDs, which I love so much. But, you know, with few exceptions, New Jersey Transit really doesn't go through too many scenic areas. I mean, there are some areas like the Gladstone Branch, the Port Jervis line, but Metro North really goes through a lot of scenic countryside. The Hudson Line is beautiful, and this section of track is beautiful. Even parts of the Waterbury Line are nice. I think the Danbury Line is nice too. I may hit those branches. Forget the new Canaan branch, the Dink.
the longest of all. Well, the Waterbury is further, but Wassaic is the furthest riding on a through train from Grand Central. There's been rumors of possibly through service to Waterbury being instituted. I know they want to expand the service state of Connecticut. That would be something if they had a Waterbury train. That's 89 miles from Grand Central. Doing Wassaic at 5:52, but we're doing very well on time. We're ahead of schedule. Return trip to Southeast leaves at 6:09, I think. 6:08, 6:09. That's just the dink back to Southeast. 10 Mile River Station, the front of the train platform there, not where I am. Next stop is Wassaic. Milepost 79.5. Should be Highway 22. Yep, Highway 22/343. The train passes through the village of Wassaic, but the train station is not really that close to it. Train station's out in the middle of nowhere. Wassaic proper here. I got 5:47. We're doing pretty good. Got a little time to kill here before I go back. It's a hiking trail here. Looks fairly new. At Wassaic, I know you can pick up the Upper Harlem Rail Trail that runs on the old railroad right-of-way. It goes up to, I think, Millerton. Yeah, look at that. They got a nice wooden bridge here for the bicycle path, hiking trail. This was not here the last time I came up this way, which is in 2019. Back before all this pandemic nonsense started.
We're now arriving at the Wassaic station. Final stop, the Wassaic. Last stop, don't forget your personal belongings. Have a happy and safe night.
Anyway. we're coming into the station. Yeah, note there's nothing out here. It's rural America out here.
Okay, last stop.
Yeah, it sure is. Nice ride. Beautiful ride. Well, there's no other equipment here besides this, so he's probably going to be my train back to Southeast in about 20 minutes. Yeah, that's the schedule. So between now and 11 o'clock at night, it's going to be kind of busy. Gonna head back on train 4980 to Southeast, and I'll connect to Grand Central. And here at Wassaic, you can see the rural nature of this area, the surrounding hills. Pretty sight. Looking south from the station, CP 182, milepost 82.